Okay, so as computational scientists, we have some problems we need to solve using numerical methods. And it is a pain to choose the correct numerical method for your problem because there are so many. And so what people tend to do is to use personal preference or personal experience to choose the correct method, but usually what they choose is not exactly the correct method. We want to remove this bias from the choice of the numerical method. And so, for instance, the main question is which solver should I use, but there are lots of other questions like how should you configure your solver, what kind of grid discretization should you use, for instance, what kind of time integrator should you use to integrate in time your equations, and then of course there is the time step size, the grid spacing, and there are other dimensionalities I don't show here, like the floating point precision and the implementation, the caching strategy. There are lots of questions here. We want to address these questions. So our goal is to minimize the runtime or the energy consumption under some accuracy constraint. So for instance, we want to impose a minimal accuracy to our solvers and to choose the one which minimizes the energy consumption or the runtime. So the first thing we do, and this is our optimization strategy, is we identify the options we have. In this case, I consider finite difference solvers. For instance, a third order upwind stencil for the spatial discretization and the fourth order time integrator. But there are a lot of options, of course. We perform performance modeling on these solvers. So we try to get an estimate of the runtime from the starting of the simulation to the end of it. And on the other side, we perform also accuracy modeling. So we try to estimate, in this case using von Neumann analysis, what will be the final error look like. So by using these two models, then we can set up our real optimization problem and tune our configuration parameters for our solvers so that, for instance, we constrain the accuracy and we minimize the runtime. But other optimization goals are compatible with our strategy, of course. In the end, you see some results here. These are some results for GPU simulations. We perform a lot of simulations, so it means we actually had to implement all these methods in order to compare them. And the gray squares, they show the actually experimentally found best solvers along with their best configuration. We want to get rid of this first process of implementing these solvers and perform the experiments. We just want to use our models to predict the best solver. And the red dots, they show the best solver in and their configurations under different accuracy constraints. And we can show that our optimization strategy will identify the optimal solver, just like the experimental results, but it doesn't require experiments. So it is much cheaper to do, much simpler to do, and you get to the same results in a very accurate way. So this is the end of the poster.